Hi guys, I'm Susie. I wanted to share this fun and easy trout to paint. Right here I have 11 by 14 inch canvas. I have three brushes that I'm using. One is this the biggest flat brush I have here. That is a 1 inch across, but it would be fine if you have a flat brush that maybe is a half inch to an inch, or even a little bit wider is fine. Whatever you're comfortable with, or whatever you have. And this one is a 1/4 inch flat brush, and this one I just call my round brush. So anyways, I'm gonna get started here. It's kind of like a warm up, but I like to wet the canvas. That way when I start painting, the paint seems to flow better, and I'm going to start with the background or the sky. So I got it damp, but you don't want it dripping wet. So it is nice and damp now. And for the sky, I'm just going to have it a simple light blue sky. So I'm going to dip my biggest flat brush in some white paint and a little bit of baby blue. And I'm just gonna go across the sky like this. And I chose to use a real light sky because I just want the fish to pop out on this painting. I want the focus to be on the fish, on the trout. So I sell these trout paintings as kits, and if you order a kit, this trout will be pre-drawn on the canvas. And as you're painting, if you go over the trout a little bit, that's okay, because that's what I love about acrylic paint, is if you make a mistake, it's easy to correct it just by painting back over it. I'll add a little bit more blue up here. This line here is where the water starts, and I'm going to use white and a royal blue or cobalt blue. And I'm just going to pretend that I'm brushing in waves because, you know, that's kind of fun. And I'm still using my biggest flat paint or paintbrush. And I'm just using the edge and just going up and down like waves flow. There isn't any wrong way of doing it. It's however you want the water to flow. It's a nice wavy lake. So now I'm going to start on the fish. I'm going to use this round brush for the eye. I always like to start with the eyes, whether it's a fish or animal or a bird, but everybody has their preference. preference. Some people like to do the eyes last. I just like to do the eyes because it seems like the animal or the fish or the bird comes alive. So I'm going to paint in the eye. I've got the pupil in there. I'm going to paint a little brown around the pupil. I'm going to use the same brush. I'm going to dip in brown and white and put a thin layer of paint around the lips here. I'm going to use a smaller flat brush for the fish's body here. And on the top, I'm going to use a couple of tones of green. I got like an evergreen color, and I love this color, lime green. I'm actually going to dip my brush in both greens. Black to the brush, because on top I'm gonna put some dark shading on top of the fish, give it a more 3D look. I'm finding the more color tones you use, the more depth you can have in a painting. And there's Moose, he's checking everything out. I'm going to do the middle part in pink. I'm dipping in pink and white. think the gill's pink too. The bottom here, that's like a baby blue and white. It's actually the same colors I used for the sky. I think I need some more blue. Paint this fin up here green. I'm gonna add a little black to that green. Get some depth to the fin. Moose. You hear my dog Moose. He's my little protector. Somebody walked by, so he's gotta protect his mama. Painting the other fins a little brown and white. Black again. I got everything covered. Now I'm just gonna keep layering on the fish till I'm happy with it. And I think on the top layer of greens, I'm just gonna add some more green tones. I got this pretty gold metallic color. You know, sometimes you on the fish, it does look like it's sparkly. So I'm gonna brush a little gold metallic across this. And the pink too. I like the gold metallic and the fins also. Where the pencil marks are, I'm just putting a heavier layer of paint to cover those up. It's okay if the pencil mark shows up a little bit. Found that the best color to cover up my pencil mark is white. So sometimes you might have to put a layer of white over the pencil mark and use whatever color back over the white that you want to use. That makes sense. So I'm going to put some black dots on the fish. One easy way to put dots on anything is use the top of your paintbrush, and I'm going to dip it in black paint and just dab dots. It's fun.
Gotta have fun.
The little dots on the fin too. Oops. That was too big of a dot. But I'm gonna paint a white line around the outside of the fish's eye. And I'm gonna dot a little white in the pupil. Sometimes that gives it more life. Debating whether to paint some green in the water. I figured, why not? I'll try it. Maybe just a little. I love green and blue colors together. Green is my favorite color.
Try to paint in some splashing waves.
Maybe I'm going to take my biggest flat paintbrush. Maybe just go like that. So what do you think? It's pretty easy. Pretty easy trout to paint. And I could, you know, play around with this for longer, but darker tones at the bottom of this splash. Well, thanks for watching, and of course, if someone gets this kit, they could, you know, work longer on it and put more detail in it if they would want. And I will have the kits available. They're 11 by 14 inch. They're $20, and it includes the pre-drawn canvas, instructions, paint, and a couple brushes. Thanks for joining.